Morning, everybody. It's August 30th, Monday, start of another new week. Had just a great weekend working with Susanna Hoffs in the studio. We got a bunch of great songs. She's really a good singer. I really only knew her work from her days in the Bangles. And this stuff is really, really cool. She's got really a lovely timbre to her voice, and she's one of the sweetest people I've met. We were having just a great time with Peter Asher producing, and it's been Jeff Allen Ross on guitar and keys, and Russ Kunkel on drums, and myself, and then Susanna singing, and Nathaniel Kunkel's been engineering it, and it's just been this really lovely thing. This guy has a really great home studio. So, I mean, it's hard to believe it's a home studio. It's a great studio out in the hills of Malibu. So we've been up there working. The only thing that sucks is the drive for me. It is a shit drive. And it seems like every time I go, there's just some kind of a crash on the freeway that's hanging things up, or going over Malibu Canyon. I can haul over Malibu Canyon just great. I always end up with somebody in front of me who's a chicken driver, and they're putting along at like 25 miles an hour and braking at every curve, and you're just going, what are you doing? I'm losing my mind. You just want to run them off the road. I mean, when I'm out doing things like that, if I see cars piling up behind me, I pull over to the shoulder, let them go by if I'm going to drive like that, and you let them go on their way, and then you get back in. But these people, their whole world is just them. They don't care about all the people that are behind them, frustrated. So, and then today's gonna, I'm going to pick up Jeff. Needed a ride today, Jeff Allen Ross. So I'm going to pick him up on the way. So that's going to add a little time to the equation. So I'm getting this done right now. It's 7:50 in the morning, and I'm going to get things together here, and then hit the road and go pick him up, and then head to the studio. It's our last day now, and then in about a week, I guess, we're going to go back in for two more days. Cooch is going to be there with us today, which will be great to have his guitar on it. And then the next time we come in, I think Waddy's going to be playing guitar. But really a nice album. It's turning out really, really good. So I'm excited about that. And it's just great to be back in the studio with some friends and some great music. Let's see. So what else is going on? My heart's really concerned for all my friends down in New Orleans and in the Louisiana area with this hurricane that's gone through. I saw some videos from it. It's unbelievable. You know, as much as we have issues out here in California, people, you know, talk about the big one and waiting for the giant quake that's going to, you know, send us all into the ocean or whatever. Boy, every year I look at like Tornado Alley and people in the floodplains of America and in the way of hurricanes. And I'll tell you, the uncertainty of what potentially could happen out here maybe once every 50 or 100 years or something like that. I'm not that worried about being a Californian. But my heart really goes out to the people that are getting slammed in this really difficult weather situation. I have to make this one a kind of a quickie, just because I've got a bunch to do before I hit the road. And yesterday I really slammed and nailed, did three cameos for people, and hopefully they're happy with those. And so I was thinking about just something that would really be kind of a fun way to kick the day off. And I remembered doing an album with a really great kind of a jazz fusion sax player named Ronnie Laws. And we did this back in 1983 called Mr. Nice Guy. And it was, I think, Ronnie's eighth studio album, or eighth album, at least. And his brother, his older brother, was the great jazz, flutist or flautist, Hubert Laws. There's always that question. James Galway, one of the great flute players of all time, was on the Johnny Carson show one night, and Johnny looks at me and goes, "So tell me, are you a flutist or a flautist?" And Galway looks at me and goes, "I don't know, I play flute." So whatever you want to call it, that's what it is. But Ronnie Laws is great, sax player. And on this album, we have myself and the great Carlos Vega on drums, Greg Matheson on keyboards, Michael Boddicker on synth, Paul Jackson Jr. on guitar, Lenny Castro on percussion, and Ronnie Laws is on sax and vocals, and Greg Matheson produced this. And this track was written by Greg Matheson and Trevor Veach. And we were a team for many, many years with this lineup of characters. Trevor contracted a whole lot of sessions that we did, from the president of the island of Tonga to Beverly D'Angelo. We did all kinds of projects, and it was always fun. The band was always great with, you know, having Carlos and Greg on them, and Paul, little Paul Jackson Jr., who's just one of the great guitar players ever. So I wanted to go ahead and just start the day off with something that feels good, and this is a song called In the Groove, and this is Ronnie Laws. So here we go.
Thank you.
did lots of sessions with that kind of a vibe on them and stuff. I always loved it, man. It's really just good feeling stuff. And I just closing my eyes and seeing Carlos sitting there playing, man. He was such a treasure to play with, and the loss of him was so monumental to our music community. It brings me joy every time I hear something I played with him, and it breaks my heart to know that he's no longer with us, because he was just one special cat. Now, something here I'll show you. For those who don't have, subscribe maybe to Facebook, this was really great in the recent issue of Music Connection. They did a whole article about the immediate family in there, and we are so appreciative of the support we've gotten from Music Connection. It's really a great publication. And then, for those who haven't seen it yet, here is our new CD. It's got the songs on the back. When you open it up, there's the kids right there. These are the incorrigible little punks. So there is our new CD. And also, people were asking questions. The other day when I did the Charlie Watts thing, they said, hold on, let me grab this thing. They said, what's that? What's that white box on your counter? This was a gift I got from Judith Owen. This was for my birthday. This is a cast hand. It's like in a latex here. It's a little bit like, what was it? Harrison Ford, when he was in the carbonite or whatever that was in Star Wars. So this is a finger in there. I didn't want anybody to think this was some kind of like a plaster caster. It's like some weird phallic thing going on in the back. So it's just this little box with this casting in it. So that's what that was. Here, put that back. It sits right next to my Thomas the Train with my, this is the one I told the long, long story about the wonderful, fabulous family that I met in the UK and have loved these people since 1990 when I met them. And there's a whole very early video all about meeting this family, and it's still one of my very favorite videos of all these hundreds and hundreds and hundreds of videos, was reminiscing about these incredible people. So I got a packed day. I'm gonna have to get ready here to hit the road and go pick up Jeff Allen Ross and get to the studio, cut a bunch more tracks, and I really look forward to that. It's we are having just a great time, and I wish I could post stuff from it, but it's really not cool to post videos from a studio on a work in progress, only because it's not fair to the artist, because what you would hear may not represent the finished product. But I'll see if there's anything. There was a really funny technical moment yesterday, that if something like that happens today, I will grab it. That just was one of these things that just went on for ages, technical problem in the studio, and then watching a whole bunch of people gathering, trying to figure out what the problem was, and the melding of the minds. It was like I just sat there just kind of going, wow. This is really good. So if something like that happens tomorrow, I'll be on the ball and grab it, and share one of these brilliant studio moments with you. But until then, I am going to just say there's so much to think about in this world right now, between what the people of the Gulf area and New Orleans and Louisiana and the adjoining areas that are being affected by this storm. My heart's with you guys. My heart's with all the Haitian people that are still suffering so terribly from the earthquake and the hurricane that went through there, with the people desperately trying to get out of Afghanistan, the people suffering in the medical community. I mean, it's just, well, I don't know if we're in some, like the pendulum is always swinging. I don't know if we're in some like weird low ebb of this pendulum waiting for it to swing back up and start improving. But boy, there's a lot of stuff a lot of human tragedy taking place right now. And animal tragedy. I mean, God knows, in every one of these situations, there are so many animals. The California wildfire, at least the West Coast wildfires, because this isn't limited to California. This is going all the way up California. Just the amount of loss and misery and stuff going on. It's a very, very hard period. So I try to maintain some positive energy throughout it all. You know, if you can be of any help, you are. Otherwise, just stop for a minute and count your blessings that you're not in the middle of some horrific situation. And it's a tough one. So I was glad to start the week off with something perky and just a nice groove and nice playing by everybody. It's a great band and great artist. So I'm going to get running now. Thank you all you healthcare workers, though. You guys are really just being pressed, especially with all the other things going on with these catastrophes in the world. Your focus is so much on helping COVID patients. And then when you start adding the injuries and problems that come with disasters, boy, I can't imagine, you know, what your lives are like. I mean, here I am, this kind of a weenie going off just to the studio to make a record while you guys are just slammed. It's amazing. So I'm out of here. I will see you all tomorrow. I wish you all the very, very best. And just be good to yourselves, your family, your friends, and your community. And we'll get through all of this. So take good care. Bye-bye.